One of the questions we get a lot of is, what does an AC line reactor or a DC choke do for my drive system in reducing harmonics? So this is a DC choke, and this is an AC line reactor that you might find in front of a 30 horsepower drive. This would be in front of the drive. The DC choke, there would actually be a pair of them or two of them inside the drive. I'm going to show you real quick an example or an analogy of what a choke does. When we say the word choke, we constrict the flow of harmonic currents or high frequencies. If I took a hose and I had water flowing through this hose, and I constricted the flow or pinched this hose, I wouldn't be able to get as much water through it. And it would constrict the flow of the water through the hose. So in a similar way, if we have conductors in the power system and we have line reactors or DC chokes constricting the flow through the power system from the harmonics, which are high frequencies, we're not going to allow as much high frequencies to come out of the drives and flow back into the power system. Now, if we take a look at this graphic shows about 80% distortion for a drive that has no line reactor in front of it. In fact, every drive has about 0.5% built into it inherently in the conductors. But if we purposely put a 3% reactor or choke, we get a reduction of about half. We get down to about 40% distortion. Now, if I had a transformer in front of my drive, what would that do? Well, the transformer impedance, you know, a typical impedance on a transformer might be 5 or 6% impedance. That impedance acts like a line reactor does in front of the drive. So it constricts the flow of the harmonic current. The question is, if I put more impedance in, do I, you know, create a significant amount of reduction? And it's kind of diminishing returns. So if you look at this graph, we go from, you know, 0.5% to 3% to 5%. You can kind of see diminishing returns. If I go as high as 10%, for example, I wouldn't get, you know, double the amount of reduction as I get with 5%. So it's, again, diminishing returns. So as we look at that, how much does my transformer come into play if I have a transformer in front of my drive? Let me show you an example of putting a transformer in front of a drive and what we would do to reduce the harmonic currents. So if I have a transformer, let's say it's a 30 kVA transformer, and I have a drive, and let's say that drive is 30 horsepower. Well, horsepower is about equivalent to kVA. So if I have 30 horsepower, I have about 30 kVA. Now, if this impedance, or Z, is 5%, then I effectively have about a 5% line reactor, because most of that impedance is inductance. But what happens is, what if this drive is not 30 horsepower? What if I have a 15 horsepower drive here? Well, the equivalent impedance then would be 15 kVA, because we said kVA is equivalent to horsepower, over 30 kVA, times the 5%. So I'd effectively get about 2.5% impedance or reactance in front of that drive. And again, so the reduction is going to be, instead of being something like this, I may get something like this, which is going to have more harmonic current involved with the system. So again, as we look at line reactors, DC chokes in front of a drive, it's the most cost-effective benefit to put inside a drive or in front of the drive, because it does the most for the least amount of money. It doesn't get you below the levels maybe of IEEE 519 off the shelf, but it's a significant reduction. And all of our DG1 drives, for example, have 5% DC chokes built into them. So I would highly suggest looking at buying drives that have that impedance built into them off the shelf.